this video, I'm going to share three ways of how you can get your videos to go viral and how people are getting their videos to go viral in this simple video. So if you want to find out how to get a video to go viral, even with no subscribers, keep on watching. How's it going, guys? And welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, I'm Simplicity. Hope you're having a wonderful day. And if you are brand new to the channel, we're all about building your brand, business, and impact online through social media marketing. So maybe you want to quit that 9-to-5 job, start a side hustle, even create a business, and turn your dream into a career, then consider subscribing, clicking that big red button down below, and join the Creator Nation. If you did enjoy this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. It really does help support the channel, helps us get out there to reach more people and turning their dream into a reality. Before I do get into the video, if you do want to go ahead and help support this channel, I do have some merch that you can go ahead and purchase, just like the one I'm repping right now. There's some subscriber tees, iPhone tees, some pretty humorous type ones as well. Check out the links in the description. Go ahead and check those out if you really do want to help support me and help support this channel so we can keep creating videos and to help you grow on YouTube. I would really appreciate it. So the first tip or the first idea of having a viral video is you need to have a look at what is trending on YouTube. If you didn't know already, there's a trending tab exactly for this, and this is going to tell you what's trending on YouTube. You can start to determine why things are trending, and this is going to help you to give you ideas of how you can create videos on those trending topics to get your video to go viral. So depending on your type of niche, you want to make sure that you're going ahead and creating a video that actually makes sense for your particular topic. Let's take a really simple example, and let's say you're a channel all about creating comedy. Let's say you create little skits and things like that, all based on your YouTube channel. So when you go ahead and want to create something on a trending topic, how can you go ahead and almost recreate what's already trending to bring in that fluctuation, bring in that audience into your small YouTube channel? Well, there's actually a really simple way of doing this. Let's take a real simple example, and let's say there's a new music video that's doing really well at the moment. You're probably thinking, how can I, as a comedy channel, recreate a trending topic that has absolutely nothing to do with my niche? I know for a fact that my audience is not going to care about this new music video. The chances of my audience to enjoy that video, especially if you're just going to go ahead and recreate that video, obviously a music video is probably not the best example because there's issues with doing even covers of music videos, and you definitely can't just go ahead and steal that video. But the idea behind trending videos, guys, is making sure that you're seeing what is trending and then how you can use that particular that funnel of an audience into your YouTube channel. And the way to do this is because people are searching for that trending topic, if you create a video about that topic, you're going to have a much greater chance of people finding that because they're going to be searching for that trending topic and your video is likely to pop up. Now, I'm not saying that your video is going to show up at the very top. There's no way you're going to rank in a trending topic. But you have a greater chance of people finding you in search because people are searching for that topic. So if we take that simple example, let's say you're a comedy channel and there's a music video that is currently trending at the moment. How can you use that trending video to funnel in traffic to your YouTube channel? Well, you can actually go ahead and you can take that music video and you can do a skit on that music video. So it's not a cover, so you don't have to worry about any legal issues behind it doing a cover video. You want to stay away from that at all costs because it's very, very risky in terms of doing covers. And of course, a cover wouldn't really make much sense when you're most likely not a musician and probably can't do a cover in the first place. So you want to go ahead and create a skit, create a comedy skit about that music video. You can have your own views on it. Did you like it? Did you think it was terrible? It's not just reacting to that music video, you're actually creating your own idea on that trending topic. And if you can go ahead and use those main keywords from that trending topic, so that when people search for that particular trending topic, your video is going to come up, it's going to give you more results, and any video that is ever going to go viral starts with YouTube search. It is the number one place to get the most views for your video. Once you start ranking in YouTube search and people are loving your video, more and more people will find it, you'll start getting recommended on homepages, on suggested pages, and that is when your video can truly go viral. Now, a lot of people think that for a video to go viral, it has to be done within the first week, within the first day. Well, there's some kind of limitation of what is considered as a viral video. In this particular video, when we say a video has gone viral, we're talking about a small YouTube channel that gets no more than 5,000 views at the very maximum, and they suddenly get a video that gets like 30,000 views. That in this instance and for this particular video is what we're going to call a viral video. It's a video that's done greater than all of your other videos, and you want to find out how you can replicate this and have another video to go viral. And the first way to do that is, like we said, with trending topics. So if you haven't already, go ahead and check out the trending tab in YouTube and find what videos that you can use to create videos on that trending topic to get more views and give it a chance to go viral. Number two is another great way for a video to go viral is to create comparison videos. Now, the best time to do this, it's not really necessary, but if you can pick your timing well, if you go ahead and create a comparison video on something that's just recently come out, so let's say, for example, when the new iPhone 12 comes out, you could go ahead and create a comparison video on the iPhone 12 compared to the iPhone 11 Pro. And a comparison video is really, really great because it's going to be what we call evergreen content. So even if that particular video doesn't really get picked up at the very start, because you're probably going to be competing with really big channels, really big tech channels, and they're more than likely going to generate those views. But the reason why a comparison video has a greater chance of going viral, and remember, we're all about trying to create viral videos, comparison videos are a great way to give yourself a greater chance of having a viral video. And the reason for this is you're creating videos that people are going to be searching for, and that's what evergreen content is. This video that you create about talking about whether the iPhone 12 is worth it, is the iPhone 11 Pro better? This video is going to be something that people are going to be searching for even years down the road. Another reason that a comparison video is so powerful is whenever somebody's going to go ahead and buy that particular product, they're generally going to do their research first. They're going to say, should I get the iPhone 12 or should I just get the iPhone 11 Pro because it's cheaper? Your video is going to be the answer to their problem. And that's what YouTube is all about. You want to make sure that you're creating a video that somebody's going to be searching for and you're going to be answering their question. And that's the power of YouTube. So making sure that you create comparison videos and telling people everything that they need to know about those two products that they're most likely going to be looking at comparing between the two to decide which one they should purchase, which one they should spend their hard-earned cash on, and your video is the solution to their problem. Now, of course, with comparison videos, you are going to be competing with, like I said, other large tech channels, so it can be very hard, especially if you're expecting your video to just take off as soon as you upload it. These things can take time, so just remember that it can take 90 days before a YouTube video to even start taking off and getting traction. So if you do create this video and in the first month you're getting barely any views, nobody's finding it in search results, as long as you're getting views in search results, there's still a chance that video can get picked up later down the road. That's just how the YouTube algorithm works. As soon as it starts getting views and people are enjoying that video, which they will be because you're answering their questions, you're telling them what iPhone they should buy, then there's good chance that video is going to go viral because you're a solution to somebody's problem. And that's what you need to remember about YouTube, guys. Be a solution to somebody's problem. Create a video for a particular audience. If you can give that audience a solution, they're going to enjoy your video, and that means that YouTube is going to start picking it up and recommending it to more people. So comparison videos are truly powerful, but make sure you have a look at what products are coming out. That gives you a good idea of what you can do comparison videos on, and go ahead and start creating some comparison videos to be that solution to somebody's problem. Tip number three for creating a viral video is kind of similar to tip number two. It's creating an unboxing video or a review on a new product. Once again, this is going to be something that people are likely to be looking at when it's just coming out. Now, you're probably thinking, once again, you're going to be competing with other tech channels. How can you, as a small channel with maybe no subscribers, compete with such a large market? Well, if you didn't know already, and there's a lot of other small YouTube channels that have done this, if you can get them first, if you can get that product before it's released to everybody else, that is when new products can be really powerful. So if you can find a way to get in there first, be the first person to review that product, that is where your video can go viral. So with a new product review, you need to make sure that you're getting it as soon as you possibly can. Now, sometimes this can be damn near impossible because these larger YouTube channels are generally given the products from the brand themselves. But what you'll realize is they'll be limited to not be able to create that video until the actual product has been released. So there actually is a really good chance that if you can find a way to get that product before those large channels have released that video and you're the only solution to that person's problem, that video is going to go viral. Possibly even if it's a terrible video, if you're the first person to release that video, your video is going to go viral. So new product reviews and unboxings are really, really powerful. Obviously, if you've already got a good audience that is going to enjoy that kind of content, it's gonna do all right anyway. But if you're a small channel with even no subscribers, this is a great way to really take off and get a video to go viral. If you get picked up as the authority in that niche, just because purely you beat everybody else to the punchline, that video will take off. There's lots of examples of people who have done this, like with the new iPad Pro, a guy who was a small channel, he had like 10 subscribers, and he managed to get the iPad Pro before the larger tech channels were allowed to release their videos. And his video within the first day got around about 200,000 views, which doesn't sound like a huge amount, but for a channel with zero subscribers, it is truly insane. So if you want to find how you can get your videos to take off just like other people have done, this is a great way to do that. So guys, those are the three ways of how you can get your videos to go viral with some simple things that you can look out for to help you create amazing content, evergreen content that people are going to be searching for, they're looking for the answer for, and your videos are going to be the solution to their questions and to their problems. And that is what YouTube is all about, and that's how a video goes viral. As long as it's answering a question and people are finding the answer that they like and they like what they're hearing, that video is going to do well because people are going to watch it for a large portion of time. The YouTube algorithm is going to see that people are enjoying it. They're going to push it out to more and more people. It's going to do well. It's going to blow up on YouTube. If you're wanting to know how can you create a video that people are going to enjoy and that people are interested in, these three ways are going to help you to do that. So if you did enjoy this video, make sure to subscribe if you haven't already and give this video a thumbs up if you haven't already. Hope you guys did enjoy this video, and I know if you did love this video, you'll love these other videos. Go ahead and check those out, and I'll see you over there.